Welcome back, everyone, to this episode. In this one, we finish off the lighting and we begin to attach all the accessory parts. Got the impulse engine attached here. I'm just letting the glue dry right now, and I put this on here, which is this goes on the spine, and I'm working on this section here. It's a little more difficult than I thought, but it's not impossible. So let's see, everything goes in here, just like that. Now I just need to come up with the section that goes from here. Oh, and for all the additions there, I finished off the paneling and all the detailing. So now those are pretty much ready to go. Just got to clean them up a little bit, and they're ready for installation. One thing I forgot to do with the main phaser cannon is drilling a hole all the way through, and for a 0.030 fiber optic cable. So I put the hole in. Now it's ready for the cable to go through, and I got the red LED here. It's ready to go. So I'm going to put the LED in here, somewhere in here, and I'll feed the cable into the phaser cannon. And there we have it. And, all the way over in there. It's good. Just got to paint the back end here all silver. I'm going to put the resistor on it. So it's slightly up a little bit. It's in. Let's see. It's ready to go. Okay, now I got the lights in here and here now for the windows. And I also completed the extra phaser strips. Just got to install them onto the body. There we go. I got the phaser strips on now. Just gotta let the glue dry. And see on the fins here, they got the phaser strips on both sides. On both of them here. Looks good. And there we go. Looks not too bad. Pretty good, actually. Yeah. Alrighty. One step closer. Okay, the next steps are to get these on here. Just as well as I can. What I'm going to do is I'm going to rough this area up here with a little bit of sandpaper first, just to give a really good adhesion. And the warp engines, at least the tops here, will be finished. Okay, now I had these set overnight. Just going to take the clip down. What I'm going to do here is I'm going to run lines up here and down so I can put the cover on. So this way goes up to the warp engine, and this way to the engineering hull. It's going to fit on here something like this. Have to do a little bit of gouging on the back here and make it fit here and on the back here. The first thing's last. Wires up here and down here. So basically everything just channels through here. There we go. Got that done. Did a lighting test on it. Looks good. Alright. Now I can put the cover on. There we go with that. Once the glue dries, put a little bit of putty in here. Shave it smooth. Paint it up. And that's ready to go. Alright, everything is really looking good here. Now, I ran out of my 5mm soft whites, so I'm going to use these to finish off lighting up this section here. And that's all I need to do for lighting. That's it. It's all done. Well, almost. Almost. Now, with the Enterprise D future refit, it didn't have a torpedo launcher on the aft. So I was going to put a torpedo launcher on this section here. So, well, my ship, I can do what I want, right? Right. That's what I'm going to have to do here. But I'm going to put the rest of the white lights all through here and then add the torpedo launcher. Okay, now I got the red LED in the side there. I just got to drill the hole on the back here. It's going to be pretty low, probably like down in this area here. Because like on here you can see it, how low it is. It's, so probably right down in the low, and then run a third 3.30 line all the way along here. If I point the camera right, and then point around the line all the way up here to the red LED, and that'll give me my aft torpedo launcher. There you go, there's the hole there. Now I'm just gonna run this line here from the light to the hole. And there we go. So I got it right there now, and I added this extra little bit on the back there just to give the indication, hey, this is where a torpedo launcher is, you know, kind of thing. So yeah, it looks good. And you got that, the line there. Just gotta have a resistor on it, and it's ready to go. Now I'm gonna work on the rest of the lighting here. This is what I decided to do. I'm going to put the lights along the spine here, facing up, and spread the light around to all the rest of the windows. It'll save up a lot of space. I gotta drill a hole somewhere in here for the wiring. So it goes on here like that. Boof, lights up those windows there. So I'm just going to daisy chain them all the way down, and that should be more than enough. Okay, there we go. Looks just like that. Yeah, but instead of drilling a hole, you know what I see? A hole right there! Wow! Go figure, huh? I don't have to worry about drilling nothing. Yeah, it pays to open your eyes and pay attention. There we go. Look kind of messy, but it's pretty bright. Let's see if I can get it working. Woo, yeah! Nice. Alright. Okay, now I got these ready to go here. I'm figuring. And this goes in here. If I shorten these down and then I just connect them to these points here on the back, then power gets channeled up to the warp engine, But one thing I have to figure out, though, is the proper angle for this so the warp engine looks like it's level. That's the next challenge. Alright, I found an issue. Originally, I had the red LED there to the torpedo. I had to move it up to underneath here just because it was interfering with the lights in this area here. I couldn't get this body panel here to stay down and stay straight. It kept going from one side to the other. So it's rectified now. I just need to figure out the proper angle for this connected to this, and then wiring this up to the pins on the back. It's not too bad. You see that it's because I'm trying to get the level of this constant with this down here, and it's not quite right. Well, one thing I'm gonna do is to make this fit properly, I'm gonna groove it out in the back here for this here to fit up inside, and I got to adjust this here to fit over this. So groove it down, probably on an angle like this to match this angle here, and it should level the engine just a little bit more. Okay, so I got it marked here where I want to cut down into it. Not too bad. As you can see there, put the gouge in there to make that fit, and then the inside of this I had to angle the plastic there to be able to fit around the curvature of the engine here. So that worked not too bad. Good. Looks like it's gonna work. Okay, I got it all connected there. Looks not too bad. Had to do a little bit of re-gluing, but yes, it's coming along. Got it all hooked up there. A little bit of repair work to do on it, but it's looking okay. Looking real good here, boys and girls. Just got to use my putty around the edges down around here, all the way around, seal all that in. Now, it looks like a real mess in there, but I used the glue gun. Get these parts together. Right, I took the fiber optic cable out, obviously, because it would melt. One thing you gotta know about these glue guns, especially that great big one, it's really hot. And it makes the plastic very, very malleable, and you gotta be very, very careful. But other than that, I got it exactly the way it should be, the height, everything. It's looking really good. It's turning out a lot better than I thought. The only thing that I'm gonna have issues with are some of these windows up in here. I've been covered over by the glue, so they're not gonna shine as bright as I'd hope for a lot of those windows, because they've been covered over. But you know, it ultimately really doesn't matter. As long as it has some windows that are lighting up, that's, you know. I went ahead and I got these all painted. The warp grills and the tips for the Bizarre collectors all ready to go now. As well as the deflector. So just got to, was going to put these on first. And then the tips for the Bizarre collectors. Let's see, it looks good. But on the very backs in here, you see the grill doesn't go all the way to the outer part of the plastic. So you got to make sure you paint this edge in here up to about this point in the hull color. And then you can put the rest of the grills on. That's all I'm going to do for the engines right now, because I still have to put in the navigational lighting. Yeah. So for now, just put the grills and stuff on, and then navigational lighting go on last. Okay, now for installing this onto here, I got to make a little hole for the wiring for this lighting here. So once I get that done, then I can install that. Okay, now just got that in there. Nice big hole. It comes out down here. It'll come out here. Alright, there we go. It's all installed. Just got to let the putty dry. Smoothing it off. Paint it. And it'll look like this belonged on the Enterprise the whole time. Before we get on with the navigational lighting, I got 100 ohm resistors here for the torpedo launcher and the phaser cannon. So we'll get those installed. Now for this unit's lighting here, I put the hole in for the wiring. Just gotta wire it up, and that one there is done. There we have it. Pretty good. Got the power all connected there, and yeah, just gotta wait for the glue to dry, and it's, this one here is done. And then gotta finish off the navigational lighting. That's it for this episode, everyone. In the next one, we're gonna be working on the navigational lighting and the flasher circuits to go with it. Please like, subscribe, and comment. And if you have any questions, or you want me to do commission work for you, you can contact me at modelbuilder501@yahoo.ca. Thanks again. See you next time.